Alrighty, welcome to an Ultimate Masters Draft here at ChannelFireball.com. I am going to be drafting some wild mongrels today. I love mongrel in this format. I think that blue-green and red-green are both, or blue-red-green, are all awesome. And I think mongrel's a better first pick than like Garna or Plume Veil or Prismatic Lens. So start off with Dojerino. Ooh, we got Iridescent Drake. This card's kind of cool in the Blue-White Bogles deck. This is a Phantom Draft, so get your eye off that Cavern of Souls. I know some of you out there are eyeing it. Got Basking Rootwalla and Reckless Worm. I would rather just take the Rootwalla because it keeps me mono-green and lets me choose whether I want to be blue or red. And maybe I'm some combo of blue and red, but I'd rather just take the green card. Plus, Basking Rootwalla is just really powerful. It's great with Wild Mongrel. It's also great when you just cast it. So, Rootwalla over Reckless Worm, passing up on a Skywing Aven, Safehold Elite, you know, some things. Ooh, the Grave Troll. I love Satyr Wayfinder, though. There's also an Aether Snipe, which isn't bad. I like Gurmag Gangler. I've actually drafted Black-Green a couple times and had been pretty happy with it. But I think despite Grave Troll having some potential here, I think I'd rather just take Satyr Wayfinder. I found Satyr Wayfinder to be really strong. There's a lot of flashback cards. The cards like Ventral Rebirth, which I'm still taking Wayfinder over. And this helps me decide on my second color a little bit later. Not super happy with this pack. Shirai Shizo's Caretaker is kind of interesting. Shizo's Caretaker? It's a combo of Satyr Wayfinder, but I think I'd rather just take Sleight of Hand here. Blue-Green is a good combination, and I like Sleight of Hand as a way to make the deck a little bit more consistent. Ooh, Become Immense. I think I like Become Immense over to second Satyr Wayfinder. Satyr Wayfinder also a pretty good combo with Meringue River Prowler, by the way. Nice little Meringue. Become Immense is pretty strong with the Wayfinder and is good with Sleight of Hand. It's just good in the blue-green deck as a way to get a lot of damage through it. So I think I'm just going to take Become Immense over Wayfinder. That's pretty close. I love Satyr Wayfinder in this format. Ooh, and there's a Reckless Worm. Well, I'll be taking that. My only blue card is Sleight of Hand, which isn't a big deal anyway. And Reckless Worm is great. So Reckless Worm over Deranged Assistant. A lot of black-white nonsense going on here, but that's okay. Actually, I'm just going to put Reckless Worm in the 3-drop slot where it belongs. Ooh, Dark Depths, that's sweet. I didn't even know there was a new art for Dark Depths. That is nice. Probably still going to take Think Twice here. I know that I'm veering back into blue, but first of all, I like this deck has three colors a fair amount of the time anyway. Kadama's Reach and Terramorphic Expanse plus Satyr Wayfinder do help with that. Second, Think Twice is pretty strong when you mill it. It's a good discard card. It's overall a pretty strong card, and I don't find Reckless Charge and Nightbird's Clutches to be particularly compelling. So, all right, well, I'll move the cantrips back in for the time being, though. Obviously, could go either direction here. Well, a couple options here. I don't like Golgari Brownscale or Prey Upon all that much. I found them just to be a little underpowered in this format. I really want all my cards to be basically threats and card draw. Become Immense is an exception, but this card's a lot more powerful than either of these. There's also another Become Immense, though I think I like Raging Ravine more. Raging Ravine's really powerful, can help me splash red, and it's just a good threat by itself, as long as you have enough red mana. So I think I'd rather take Raging Ravine over the second Become Immense. Kind of wishing I took a Satyr Wayfinder over the first Become Immense. I love me a Satyr Wayfinder. Though once you have two, the third is not quite as compelling. So hopefully we end up in a good spot here. All right, what do we got here? Ooh, Pulse of Murasa is fine. I have not really liked foil. I know this card has made some waves in the Pauper metagame, but it's pretty hard to use in this format. So I think I'm just going to take Pulse. Can work also with the Wayfinder. It's not a really a good combo with Become Immense, but Pulse of Murasa is a good enough option already. I like it a little more in black-green because that has more of a graveyard theme and more interested in that kind of thing. But even in like blue-green or red-green, you can still potentially make use of Pulse. There's also a Verdant Eidolon. Don't have any multicolor spells here, so I'm not super thrilled about that. I'm not looking to Iridescent Drake. Cavern seems like a stretch. Just going to take a Plume Veil for the sideboard here. I've only gotten the one, kind of like 1.5 red cards here. And here, I guess I could take Spark Spitter. If I do end up Red-Green Madness, this card does do some work. And I don't think Foil, Nightbird's Clutches, or Stitcher's Apprentice are particularly good, though. I don't think Spark Spitter is anything special. I'll take Verdant Eidolon in case I end up with a ton of multicolored stuff. Spider Umbra, Vessel of Endless Rest. I don't like Defy Gravity. I guess I'll take the Vessel. There might be some three-color decks I'll end up in. Ooh, another Whirlwind Adept and a Reckless Charge. It's kind of a combo. So that pack was decent. I think the green is open. I don't know about my second color yet, though. Ooh, Kitchen Finks is a pretty strong one. I like Just the Wind. If you end up with a really focused mongrel deck, when you have like three mongrels, Just the Wind can be awesome. But kind of into Kitchen Finks or second Raging Ravine. Ravine is really nice. If I have a second Raging Ravine, it makes my mana a lot better. And this card is just such a big threat. So I think I'm just going to take a second Ravine over a Kitchen Finks here. Ooh, Young Pyromancer. Young Peasy is awesome. And I haven't gotten a strong blue signal. I think twice in a sleight of hand, that's it. So I'm just going to take Young Pyromancer over Aether Snipe here. And like Scuzzback Marauders and Last Gasp, because Young Pyromancer is sweet. Reckless Charge might be of interest at this point. Maybe we'll end up something like this, a little bit more of a red-green deck. And here we brick. Not a whole lot I'm interested in here. Don't need a second Pulse. Skywing Haven is not great. Raid Bombardment, I guess, works with Pyromancer, but it's just really not necessary. Rally the Peasants is kind of interesting with Pyromancer, but I only have two discard outlets right now, so I'm not even feeling great about that. Artisan of Kozlek is just a little too expensive, so I think I'm going to take Skywing Haven and be pretty unhappy with that pick. Well, I don't mind picking up another Basking Root Wall here. I like Hissing Iguanar with Pyromancer as well, but Root Wall is really important, and I'm really hoping to pick up at least one more Mongrel here. Brawn is also decent, but can't stop the Basking Root Wallers. Can I get a Faithless Looting? This deck would be really a fan of Faithless Looting between Pyromancer, Root Wallers, Become Immense. It would be awesome. So this is an interesting pick. There's Fire Ice, which is good, because even if you can only cast Fire, it's still pretty strong. And this deck may splash blue, though it's not looking super likely. There's Boar Umbra, which against someone without removal can be pretty strong. Just plopping on a Root Wall or Mongrel, or better yet, a Reckless Worm. There's Hissing Iguanar, though I think that's a little less powerful than the other options. Fire also has the additional benefit of it triggering Young Pyromancer, which is pretty nice. I think I'd rather just take the spell here. I think that looks a little better to me. And not a fan of any of these. I guess I'll take Canker Abomination. This is green-green 2 for usually like a 5-5 or a 4-4, which is pretty good. And there's some matchups where it's just truly excellent. Oh man, I love Mages of the Bazaar in the right deck. This is not it. I like Conflagrate, though. Conflagrate, you can play it for 3 mana to deal 1. Not the most impressive, but discarding Root Wallas and setting up a Become Immense, it has some good post-board, or sorry, discard applications. Fecundity's cool. Ooh, I will take Frantic Search here. There's a chance I end up dipping back into blue. I have the fixing for it, and Frantic Search is really good. I don't like Gamble very much. I think Frantic Search is a lot better. Okay, just the Wind Wield. I'm just going to take that. And maybe I'm going to be Teemer Madness and put a Think Twice in. Not really in for Sleight of Hand still. Wow, that's a late Aether Snipe. Get this Reckless Charge out of here. Put Aether Snipe in. So blue was kind of open. I don't really get what's going on, if we're being honest. I could also potentially be back on blue-green and splashing just Reckless Worm and Pyromancer and Conflagrate. Though, I don't know. We'll have to see what Pack 3 yields, but we're going to need some direction here. I guess I'll take Dimir Guildmage. I could, maybe there's some world where Rally the Peasants is good. Wow, it's disrespectfully late Celestial Colonnade. Wish this wasn't Phantom. Ha ha ha. Obviously these cards wouldn't be there if it wasn't. I'm not going to be playing Celestial Colonnade, but I'm taking it anyway, just on a matter of principle. And I'll take Ingot Truer for the sideboard. And Defy Gravity, not quite going to do it. All right, we need some help here. We have wonderful five blue cards, five green cards, and five red cards. Lovely. There's another Kitchen Finks. Ben for Rebirth is powerful. And then there's Hootie and the Mandrills. Hootie and the Mandrills is good. I like it a lot with cards like Frantic Search, and if I can pick up Faithless Looting. And green is the color I'm most likely to be, just because Mongrel and Wayfinder are both so important. I think I'm just going to take the Hooting Mandrills and see where we go from there. And second Conflagrate is a lot less important. Oh, I've got to take Faithless Looting. Okay. Let's hope that maybe we touch blue a little bit, but we end up main green-red. Might wield the other Conflagrate, which I wouldn't mind. And yeah, nothing comes close to Faithless Looting here, since that's what this deck really does need. Could use, if I just pick up more of the Madness Engine cards, I'll feel a lot better about this. Couple good options here. I do like Stinger Fling Spider in general, but I think I'd rather just take Fiery Temper. This deck's aggressive. I'd rather just go face here, and it's good with Pyromancer, good with Mongrel, good with looting, so Fiery Temper's nice. I don't hate Groundskeeper either, if it ends up getting their second Faithless Looting. Okay, so now we can probably take out Frantic Search. I'll play the Fire Ice regardless, but now I can just take out the Aether Snipe here and then just take second Faithless Looting and really go after Rootwalla and Reckless Worm would be high on my list of priorities here, though. At this point, where'd that go? Getting back that Canker Abomination. And maybe getting this Reckless Charge back in. I could see that being part of the plan. Whew, second young Pyromancer. That is awesome. All right, definitely getting Reckless Charge in there. Slamming the Pyromancer here, that's going to be so good. Now we're really into spells. That said, even though Conflagrate is nice with Pyromancer, I think the second Reckless Room has to be the call with Mongrel, Double Faithless Looting, and Spark Spitter as well. So second Reckless Worm here. Rolling Tumbler, not the biggest combo with a Pyromancer. I don't mind Spark Spitter, though. Now that I have Double Reckless Worm and Fiery Temper, Conflagrate, Double Rootwalla, Spark Spitter seems like it is good enough. Yeah, I could Nightbird's Clutches. I don't think I want to do that, though. I'm hoping to wheel one Conflagrate. I don't think we're going to get Undying Rage in there. Rally the Peasants is probably too cute. I guess I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ways of discarding it, plus Satyr Wayfinder. But it's only good if I'm getting Pyromancer going, and if I'm getting Pyromancer going, I'm pretty happy. I guess I could end of their turn, make a Spark Spitter token, untap, make another one, Rally the Peasants. That's just 10 right there without any other creatures going on. I think I'll pass. Oh, third Faithless Looting. Yes, yes, please. Sorry, Fire Ice, you are not as good. All right, well, now I would have loved to see another Rootwalla, but that's not going to happen. That's the last new card we get to see. Didn't wheel Conflagrate? That was in this pack. Take Undying Rage because I'm not playing any of these other cards. I need one or two more playables. I guess I could pull some Marasa. It's decent with Pyromancer, as in it's just a spell. I can get back like a Reckless Worm, which isn't bad. It's okay with Satyr Wayfinder. So Groundskeeper might be good with triple Faithless Looting as a way to, you just keep getting back lands and then discarding them to Lootings or Spark Spitters. I think I want that more than a second Reckless Charge. And could take Ulamog's Crusher that I'm not going to play. Fulminator Mage that I'm not going to play. But this is 22. I could put Undying Rage in. I could actually put Rally the Peasants in. It doesn't sound like the most ridiculous thing. Or I could Generator Servant. Nah, Generator Servant's pretty bad. I'll take a second Ingot Chewer. I don't even know how I'd end up siding that in. All right, I think we're going to try to play a Rally the Peasants here. Just because you can flash that back, and so it's kind of like a free card with all these lootings and spark spitters and whatnot. And this deck ended up pretty good. Nice little aggressive red-green madness deck with double raging green, which is really nice. And no, I'm not playing any swamps. 8-6 gives me 10 red, 8 green. Looks pretty good to me. I guess I could go to an 11th red because I have triple looting. But I don't even really want a looting on turn 1 all that often. I would rather set it up like the turn 4 for the Reckless Worm. But I guess if I have Rootwalla in my opening hand, I'm going to looting early. All right, let's save and let's get down to business. Oh, I have 16 land. Might get out of land, and that will be a mount. There we go. Bam. Now we're getting in there. Alrighty, welcome to round 1 here. And I'm going to keep this hand. This hand does need a Faithless Looting pretty badly. But even if I draw a forest, I could still start to get something going here. That's not bad. Fire, well, I would say Fire Ice, but actually just Fire plus Young Pyromancer is a time-honored tradition here. Red, red. Oh, there's a Raging Ravine. Let's just play Pyromancer. Hope my opponent doesn't have an answer to this. And if they don't, then we could start to get things going. Next turn, play Raging Ravine and Fire if they play a creature that can die to it. Oh, well, that does tie to it. Molten Birth, they make 2/1s, and they didn't get it back. All right, this works out really nicely then. Raging Ravine, cast Fire, 1/1. Make my token, kill their two things, and then next turn I can Faithless Looting. what this deck's going to want to do is try to play its fourth land before it casts Faithless Looting a lot of the time in case you draw a Reckless Worm. Another Molten Birth. And my opponent is 0-2 in coin flips. Land. So let's just looting. Make a token. Discard a Baskin Rule and I think a Groundskeeper. Yeah, because we're going to play... I guess we can't play a Mandrills right now. So let's just play a Spark Spitter. And then send with my token. Yeah, this is going to work out just nicely. No, a little more nicely. It's going to work out great. I have Conflagrate, which can get my opponent pretty nicely at any point. And I have Mandrills. Scuzzback Marauder isn't bad. 5-2 Trample comes back as a 4-1. I could spit some Sparks. Yeah, why don't I do that? So let's go Spark Spitter. Discard a Mountain. Attack with Ruul, attack with Token. Not going to attack my Elemental. I assume they're going to block Scuzzback Marauder on the Root Walla here. And then I get to play a Hooting Mandrills. I have to exile my Faithless Looting to do that, but I think that's worth it. Oh no, I don't actually, because the Root Walla's going to die. Yeah, even better. So now, land, play Hooting Mandrills. Exile everything but the Root Walla. And then next turn I can Conflagrate their 2, their 4-1 and their 1-1. What else do they have? Oh, never mind. I can Conflagrate their... Oh, wow. Okay, I have like a lot of things to do here. I think I just go Conflagrate, kill Hissing Iguana, kill Scuzzback Marauder. And then I take some damage off those Hissing Iguanas, and that's totally fine. Next turn, I can Flashback Conflagrate, discarding Reckless Worm. Which is a pretty good deal here. Okay, so they're going to nug me 3 times. I'm definitely attacking with my Elemental. I think I'm going to attack the Spark Spitter also. I'll keep the Mandrills back. Because I'm going to be happy. I don't really want to trade Mandrills for Hissing Iguanar plus Elemental when I have a Conflagrate in my graveyard. Because my opponent sees the Conflagrate. They will want to just take that double block when they can. But I will trade Spark Spitter for Iguanar because I'm not that into Spark Spitter right now. Okay. Take some damage here. My opponent's got a nice little tokens deck. Double Hissing Iguanar, double Molten Birth, but my Conflagrate's going to work them pretty nicely. We would have really loved to wheel one more Conflagrate. That would have been nice. Wow, second Pyromancer. I don't think I actually do the Pyromancer here. I think I just do this. Discard Reckless Worm. Make a token, make a worm. Attack my opponent for millions. You know the drill. Okay, red-green tokens? A little less into Rally the Peasants if we're going to be trading off a bunch of tokens. And didn't see anything that would make me want... most of my sideboard's not that good against these tokens, is it? I guess I could Undying Rage, because against red... that might just be pretty good. Just make something big enough that they can't really deal with it. Alrighty, welcome to game 2. Yeah, this hand's great. This is much better than last hand. What am I going to do here? Because with 3 Faithless Looting in my deck, I really want to hold on to Root Walla, and I'm not going to pump the next couple turns, so I think I'd rather just go turn on Ravine, turn 2 Pyromancer, and then see where we're at there. Opponent's going to play their Molten Birth, I'm sure. Seems like their plan. They're 0 for 2 right now. And 0 for 3. Alright, well, this is... I guess if I draw... Yeah, actually, you know what? I'm just going to go for it. Humph. Undying Rage, smash. I was going to say, if I draw Looting, I'll have other things to discard, and that is true. But I think I'd rather just... put an Undying Rage on the Pyromancer and get in there, and then I have Fiery Temper to back it up. Alright, they're 0 for 3. They've got to win this coin flip, right? Ha! They did not. Nice. Okay, they're not attacking with any of them, so if I attack... I actually think I just attack here, because if they quad block, then I'll trade Pyromancer for all their tokens, because I have Pulse of Marasa to get the Pyromancer back, and Undying Rage comes back nicely. And if they triple block, I can use Fiery Temper. Make it so I don't lose my Pyromancer. My opponent deciding. It's kind of awkward because this is a 4-3, because blocking with 4 is wasteful, but blocking with 3 runs into the exact problem I've demonstrated here with Fiery Temper. Oh, they're just going to chump? Well, in that case, they should have attacked me with their things. They're giving up some equity there. Land. Yeah, Root Wall of Groundskeeper. I'm just going to pass. Keep Root Wall of Pump up. And now that I've got Groundskeeper, Faithless Looting gets a lot better anyway. All right. Reckless Worm. The difficult way. Can't block, so I might as well attack the Pyromancer here. If they just want to keep chumping, that's on them. Okay, they're going to trade here. Just going to let that happen. And I'm going to play a land, and I think I just pulse. Oh, I'm not going to pulse the Reckless Room. That'd be bad. And then play a Pyromancer here. And that'll set me up nicely for next turn here, where I get to Undying Rage, the Basking Root Wall, most likely. But if I draw like a Faithless Looting or something, I get to go ahead and make some tokens off like the Pyromancer. See what they have here. Oh, this looks like a conflagrate. No, Vengeful Rebirth, killing my Pyromancer, getting back Molten Rebirth. And I have not... I've yet to hit anything else, huh? Let's just drop Undying Rage on the Root Walla. And send. My opponent can chump or take 5. Alright, and play a land, pass. If they start making their Molten Birth coin flips, things could be kind of annoying here. But, oh, Thermal Alchemist. Well, that I'm probably going to Fiery Temper, because this gets to ping me for 1 for all their spells. Oh, Pyromancer? That I probably have to Fiery Temper. Alright, let's just wait. No, let's not wait. Let's just, if I draw Conflagrate, great, that'll be awesome. Ooh, Hooting the Mandrills. I wanted to make it so I could attack with Raging Ravine. I guess I can't attack with Ravine and pump the Basking Root Wallace. So let's just... And play the Mandrills. Let's just attack. And then play a Mandrills post-combat, not eating anything from the graveyard. Plus, I want to leave a mountain in my hand in case I draw Faithless Looting. Chomperino. And just... Mandrills for the full price. No discount at all. Mandrills also doesn't get chump blocked too well. My opponent's due to win a coin flip, though. So they get to ping with Alchemist, play Molten Rebirth. See if they can win their coin flip here. Let's say they win 1 coin flip and they make 4 tokens this turn. I still think I'm in fine shape. I also got 6 life off Pulse of Marasa. It's a nice little benefit. Hasn't come up yet, but could be good. Oh, wait, what is this? Another Vengeful Rebirth. Okay, killing my Hooting Mandrills, getting back Reckless Worm. Now, that could be problematic. Ooh, Satyr Wayfinder, that's not bad. Let's play this. Okay, we milled a Conflagrate. Nice. I still think I play my land, because I want to animate Raging Ravine this turn. And then I want to send with Ravine and Root Walla here. But now, oh, let's not send with Groundskeeper. Groundskeeper is going to be important, because Groundskeeper is going to pick it back up, that other mountain, to make my Conflagrate a little bit bigger. Opponent's just taking it all? That's weird. Opponent has been kind of inconsistent as to when they chump block and when they don't. They have 7 mana. All right. If they Reckless Worm here. Also, their deck is not, I was going to say, has not been doing a good job Madnessing, but... Mad Prophet changes that entirely. So I can play Pyromancer. I can play Pyromancer, get back my land, and Conflagrate for 2. Killing the Mad Prophet. Let's just animate Ravine. And attack with Ravine and Root Wall and see what happens. No reason to attack with Satyr Wayfinder, I don't think. Undying Rage has actually been decent this game. made the Pyromancer into a bit of a threat, and it's making this root wall kind of large. So I get their card. They get another turn of mad profiting. Some mad profits here. But their blocks here are not great. If they want to kill something, they have to double block with Worm and Elemental Token. And that leaves them taking 5 off Root Wall. Yeah, that works for me. Sadly, my Groundskeeper can't get back Raging Ravine there. It's only basic lands. But I'm also about to kill my opponent with a Conflagrate. Next turn, I think they're just dead. Yeah, they really couldn't block this way. I mean, if they've drawn Pulse of Murasa, sure. But I don't think they have. And next turn, I'm going to Groundskeeper back a mountain and then Flashback Conflagrate for 4. All right, here comes Molten Rebirth. I hope my opponent just misses on the Molten Rebirth so they have some nice Complaint equity. Oh no, Fiery Temper. Well, I don't think they're playing around this Conflagrate at all. Because they could have Fiery Tempered the Groundskeeper to buy themselves a turn off Conflagrate. Instead, they just made my Conflagrate even better. Yeah, their last card's Molten Rebirth here. This is known, or Molten Birth rather. Yeah, did they get there? Oh, they won the flip. How lucky. They finally got there. All right, Conflagrate you for 4. Not even going to use the Groundskeeper. No need. All right, wabam. Conflagrate, winning games just like it does in Modern, and we are up a match. Alrighty, time for round 2. Play against Island Go, huh? Yeah, I'm just going to be Mountain Go here. I think this hand without a forest is still keepable. It's not the best hand in the world, but one forest and I'm off the races, and I've also got 3 Faithless Lootings in my deck, and I can still play a Spark Spitter. While my opponent's deciding whether to Island Go or not, I'm going to tell you about ChannelFireball.com. That is, of course, the best place for Magic strategy on the internet. We've got free strategy, and we've got lots of good sales, and of course, we will always buy your Magic cards. So, check out ChannelFireball.com, check out our YouTube page, and yeah, keep supporting videos like this one where I get to top deck forest right. Well, for not top decking a forest, at least Fire Ice can kill something, so there is that. Opponent on blue-red. Oh, Prismatic Lens. Okay, that's a good start. Ooh, Mountain is a bad draw. Mountain is probably the worst draw in my deck because green cards at least I can cast once I draw a forest. Forests are obviously the best draw right now, or at least just one forest. But Mountain doesn't do anything for me. Red spell is also fine because I can cast them. Though I suppose if I draw a Reckless Worm here, I'll be kind of happy. No, Reckless Worm. Worm, not Charge. Get you for 1. I don't think it's worth discarding. I could Reckless Charge deal 6 to them, I guess. I could have discarded it and then flashed it back. Seemed bad. Magma. That card's pretty good. Alright. Let's discard Basking Root Walla. Cast Basking Root Walla. Alright, here we're gonna get some action going. Reckless Charge, Basking Root Walla. And then this makes it look like we're just trying to use that as a madness outlet, but that when they block the 3-1, I get to Fire Ice them. Yeah. All right, Fire 1 and 1. Boom. Okay. Not the end of the world. I mean, that wasn't a great value. I guess it was 2-1 Rogue's Passage. That's ambitious in this deck. What is going on over here? Aether Snipe, bouncing my Spark Spitter. All right, well, Forest would still be pretty nice here. Another Mountain, huh? I guess I'm just going to play Spark Spitter, and I think I'm just going to hold. I don't think I'm supposed to play that Mountain. I might want to discard it, and a 5th red source doesn't really do much for me. Opponent's going to send with their Snipe. They also note they didn't play a 4th land until turn 5, so they've got a lot of spells in hand, and unfortunately they're able to cast all of them. Spark Spitter. Okay, so they're like blue-red madness here. Alright, I don't love it, but I think Mountain is going to be cashed in here, and then I'm going to play another Spark Spitter. And hope to draw green mana at some point. Oh no, am I getting counterspelled? Rune snagged. Okay, That's not the end of the world. It's not like Spark Spitter was integral to my plans here. My opponent might not even know I'm playing green. I could be playing blue-red and just having a Basking Root Wall in my deck. One of the things that is keeping me in this game, by the way, is this Become Immense. This card plus Reckless Charge, I don't know, we could end up in a spot where we just get to finish things off nicely. I don't like this. Is this a Conflagrate? This is going to kill both of my things. Oh no, it's a Treasure Cruise. Interesting. I hope my opponent just attacks with both their creatures. That actually might put me in a playable spot. We'll find out here. Okay. If I draw green, what happens here? Let's just draw green and find out, shall we? Because if I draw green, I actually think I could threaten to do some damage. Discard. At this point, I think I just discard a Mongrel. No, I'm going to discard a Mountain, I think. Make a token, and then Reckless Charge the token. Because these things have Trample, so I get to hit with the token. My opponent can take 6 here, or they can chump and take 3. Okay, they take 6, going into 5. So now I actually have an out, or if I draw a forest, Spark Spitter into a token is 9 points of trample damage out of nowhere. That could get some damage in. Then again, my opponent did Treasure Cruise and didn't play a land, so I don't think I'm in very good shape here. I'm going to take the hit again. Basically, I need my opponent to tap out or not have instant speed removal. All right, they drew a land this turn, and then I get to... Well, I need to draw a forest, and then I need to make a token, and I don't know, get a good amount of damage in. Let's see. Raging Arena, not exactly where I want to be. Just pass. I think what I'm going to do here is... Oh, man, I'm probably just going to die, actually. That was just too slow. Because my opponent's going to do what I wanted to do, which was make a Spark Spitter token end of turn, and then make one on their turn, and I think that they can attack me with both and potentially kill me. Yeah, especially if they're madnessing thing. Emrakul cool, the Aeon's Torn? My opponent, I guess, threw the breaches in this set? All right. That is wild. And just the window, okay, I'm just like super dead now. Okay, well, if I had drawn a green, you know, at any point, well, not any point, the last turn was too late. If I had drawn a green, it would have been nice. Ingot Chur against, they have multiple artifacts. Doesn't sound completely unreasonable. I could probably take out Rally the Peasants. Groundskeeper might be a little slow also. I don't like Undying Rage, they have like a bounce spell. Maybe just put in some Ingot Chewers here. Get some nice advantage that way. Get to play first. All right, here we go. This is a lot more enticing. I get to play Raging Ravine on turn 1 here. Into turn 2 Mongrel, turn 3 Spark Spitter. And I might be evoking an Ingot Chewer. We'll see if my opponent plays a Prismatic Lens. I kind of like Ingot Chewer as a sideboard card here. Because evoking to kill their artifacts, you know, their lens or Vessel of Endless Rest is a nice little play. And then later in the game, it's a 5-mana 3/3 that maybe can eat something on the way. Like, if they play a Prismatic Lens, I'm in. Okay, well, that I'm less interested in. Let's just attack with the Mongrel. Opponent can't really block here. And then we'll play a Spark Spitter. And what I really want to draw is like a Reckless Worm here. Root Walls wouldn't be bad either, because I have a Faithless Looting, but I don't have anything I want to do with it yet. Opponent also could be Sacking Generator Sorting here. Cathodian, ooh. That one I will like to Ingot Chewer. So what do you draw here? What if I play a land? I don't... But I can play a land and a Looting here. If I draw a Reckless Worm or Basking Root, we'll be pretty happy. I could also evoke Ingot Chewer on the Cathodian. And then I could pull some Morosset back. I could evoke Ingot Chewer and conflagrate the Generator Servant. That might not be horrible. Yeah, kind of like that. All right, let's configure this. And Evoking Ingature gets in 3 points of damage here, which I think is decent. And if they play a second artifact, I get to pulse it. Their Cathodian is down. They have a bunch of colorless mana, which I don't think they're going to be able to do anything with. And sadly, it's not the old days. You used to be able to mana burn your opponent with Cathodian, or of course, the original Cathodian, Suchi. That was pretty sweet. Also, this opens the door, if I draw a land and my opponent's play is unexciting, to just animate Raging Ravine and just smash. Another Generator Servant, huh? Like I said, if my opponent's play is unexciting, I'm just going to attack with everything, and I don't even care too much about this Wild Mongrel. If my opponent blocks, I probably will discard Faithless Looting to it. They just didn't block, okay. Take a million damage. Yeah, this works for me. Alright. Don't really know what my opponent's deck's up to. It looked like it had some blue-red madness stuff, but then there was like multiple Generator Servants and an Emrakul, so I assumed through the Breach. I don't really know, honestly. I could put in Fulminator Mage because they have Rogue's Gallery, but that seems... Yeah, that seems like a stretch. Alright, let's battle. Haven't really gotten any really sick madness draws. Oh, this is a start. Turn 4 Reckless Worm off of Looting is not bad. Put a mulligan to 6. Oh, they're mulligan to 6. They're going to play a Prismatic Lens. I'm just going to Ingature it right up. Whoa, bam. Let's see my opponent's up to. Terramorphic Expanse. Sure, sure, sure. Oh. Let's play Mountain. And I guess just I could just Looting now. Actually, I should have just gone Forest Root. Oh, What was I thinking? I don't think I'm supposed to compound by mistake by not playing the Looting, but I really do want to turn 4 Looting here. Terramorphic for a green, huh? Okay, well, I'm going to play Root Wall this turn. Oh yeah, second Reckless Worm means I really do want to wait on this Looting here. I'm going to Reckless Charge the Root Wall because why not? Are they going to bounce it? Sure. I'm actually completely fine with trading Reckless Charge for just the win there. Opponent's not doing much. I'm just going to play a land. And I think I'm just going to pass on the Root Walla here because basically by waiting a turn, I get to draw a card because I get to discard the Root Walla to the Faithless Looting. Oh, they have a Cathodian. This is great. We are going to crush them. Land. Faithless Looting. Discard Root Walla, Reckless Worm. Madness them both. So this is like a pretty sweet deal. I get to draw two cards. I mean, I do all lands, but that's what flashing back Looting is for. And I get to play two things. So pretty big game. Next turn, I'm just going to hard cast Ingature on that Cathodian and just run rampant here. I do have to watch out for Through the Breach. You know, when your opponent has Emrakul Through the Breach in their deck, it is always dangerous. It's just hard cast Ingature, see if my opponent's got Rune Snag. They do, unfortunately, but now I just get to attack with Reckless Worm. And then next turn, I can flashback Looting to play another Reckless Worm if I want. Do they have it? They have Urban Evolution, draw 3 and play an additional land. Okay, well, that's a good one. Not going to get them out of this particular situation, I don't think. I think it's worth Looting here. Drawing another Root Wall would be pretty sweet too. Alright, let's discard Reckless Worm and a Mountain. And then play a Reckless Worm here. And I might be able to go Mongrel Flashback Reckless Charge next turn. Also, my opponent's really down on board. Like, I've got 2 4/4s and kind of essentially a 3/3 in play. Pattern of Rebirth. When this dies, they get to search their library for a creature. That's interesting. So they get to get their Emrakul and put it into play. I guess I should not kill their thing. Let's go Seder Wayfinder. And if I spike a land, I get to play Mongrel and Spark Spitter. I have to kind of kill my opponent in one shot. Oh, man. No land? That's unfortunate. All right. Mongrel. And pass the turn. and I guess hope my opponent can't kill their own Cathodian. Though if they can kill their Cathodian, they have to main phase get Emrakul, and that's a lot less powerful. Magma, so they get to sack their Cathodian. Wow, okay. I guess so. Okay, let's figure out how we're going to beat this. It's probably going to involve attacking with everything. And seeing what my opponent does. So they're going to block Reckless Worm. So if I just pass, they're taking 6 right now. They're going to 6. Because if I pump the Root Walla... Oh, no, they're taking 7. Because if I pump the Root Walla, they can throw a Cathodian at it. So I think I just pass here. Because this only gets to pump once per turn, unfortunately. All right, assign Trample. They go to 5. They get a bunch of colorless mana. They're going to get an Emrakul. This is true. Alright, and this can do it to any target, but it's non-land only, so I'll let them phase out the damage. Now I can Fiery Temper the Magma, but that hasn't really accomplished much. I think, let's see, if I have 7 mana, I can Pulse and play Young Pyromancer, but that doesn't do much. Let's just go Spark Spitter and then pass, and I have Pulse of Marasa up in case my opponent wants to go for some kind of kill here. And I'm going to have to sack 6 permanents, but I think I can do that. I'll sack 4 land, Root Walla, and Seder Wayfinder. And then my opponent attacks me. I go to 5, but I can Fiery Temper my opponent, and then I can make a token of Spark Spitter. They're at 2, and I have 11 points of Trample coming in. That seems pretty good. I could also Fiery Temper them, and then sack my lands and keep Root Wall and Seder Wayfinder. That's interesting. Okay, so yeah, my opponent's going to attack, as they should. So it really comes down to whether I think it's better... It's got to be better to keep the lands, I think. So I'm going to sack 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because this way, if I draw a land... I'm missing the land on the Wayfinder. Hurt me a lot this game, actually. This way, if I draw a land, I get to... I can pull... No, I can't pull some Ross of the land back, actually. I don't have enough time for that because I need to Fiery Temper. I'm trying to figure out a way where I can Reckless Charge something also. Like the Reckless Worm. And I don't have enough mana to do everything I want to do. Though I have Pulse Marasa up, there's a chance my opponent might try to like burn me out. We'll see what options they have. They have Treasure Cruise, okay. I like them kicking things off with Treasure Cruise, because that makes it less likely that they can provide a good defense here. Spark Spitter. Okay. Okay, Fiery Temper you. They've already used one Rune Snag. I'm at 5, so they can't kill me. So they're not... Oh, they have another Rune Snag? Okay. So now if I make a token... Near to draw a land. If I had drawn a land, it still would have been good enough, actually. Because now I can... Well, so if I Reckless Charge, I have 11 points. Wait, no, this is enough. Hold on, Reckless Charge the Reckless Worm, very flavorfully. Now I have 11 points of Trample. They have 7 points, but the Spark Spitter is the last point. Whew. Wait, they foiled to win the game? They drew foil and Rune Snag? Oh my god. Oh, that is awesome. All right, well, you know, that's good beats. I have to give my opponent credit for that. That's pretty funny. I end up a point short at the end. Not playing root wall on turn one, I guess, did the trick. But man, I did lose to foil double counterspell with two mana up. Whew. All right, my opponent certainly earned it this game. Well, let's go to the last match here. Whew. Welcome to round three, but I'm still reeling after game two there. I deserved it. Everything happens the way it's supposed to. I played mountain on turn one instead of a forest. Ended up a point short. You know, despite my opponent, I think, getting fairly lucky to have that sequence of cards to win the game at the end. Had I played correctly the whole game, then I wouldn't have gotten them out of it. So, we're 1-1. Let's see if we can get our 2-1 victory here. I'm not going to lead with Faithless Looting because I don't really have anything I want to discard. If I had a Root Willow, that might be different. I'm going to play turn 2 Mongrel into turn 3 Reckless Worm. That is my plan. Ghoul Caller's Accomplice. It's a 4-mana 2-2, or 2-mana 2-2 that when it dies, you can also just make it into a exile to make another 2-2. Ooh, Maelstrom Pulse. That's a good one. Land. Send with Mongrel. I mean, I suspect we're going to win this game in a landslide. Wow, really? All right, they really want to get more cards in their graveyard, I guess. Let's Madness out a Reckless Worm. The red Mongrel. So they mill two more when the crow dies, as the crow flies. At that point, you should just double block. Then I'd have to discard a lot more cards to keep my Mongrel. Another crow. Wow, my opponent really wants to get this Gurmag Angler out. The Bloodflow Connoisseur. So they have some kind of sacrifice deck, as it would appear. Let's go Young Peasy. And then attack with both and have fire in case of a double block here. Okay, cast fire, 1/1. Wow, we are really working our opponent here. As if my deck wanted to make up for its pitiful performance last round, it is just steamrolling the opponent. This isn't close to being close. Oh, spider spawning. Never mind. It's close to being close, but it's still not over. They can quad block the Reckless Worm and double block the Mongrel. I kind of want a looting now, so let's just do that. Discard Groundskeeper and a land. I could just discard two lands, play Groundskeeper, and then I can Groundskeeper back a land and play it, and I think just pass. Spider spawning is a pretty good one. It is at that. I think I'm still doing okay here. Because, yes, they can spider spawning again in a turn or so. Oh, wow, Bloodflow Connoisseur. This is pretty big. Big if true. All right, there's a Golgari Thug. So I'm going to have to watch out, figure out how I'm going to kill my opponent here. So right now, if I discard Rally and Flashback, that's 3. It leaves me 2 mana. I could technically cast Become Immense as well. So let's see if I attack with everything. Rally plus Become Immense means the Reckless Worm's 12 points of trample. I don't think we're... So what happens if I attack with everything? They put one token there, one token there, one token there. It's 3. They might put Bloodflow Connoisseur on like one of the 1/1s. One token on Mongrel, and then like... They block 1/2, but then they block 4 things, and then I use Rally. I don't really want to talk about the Pyromancer. If I use Rally, it makes it so my Reckless Worm takes out a lot of, like, this would be a 7/7. Yeah, this actually seems almost exactly good enough. Basically, like, in order for blocks to end up too badly for me, they run the risk of dying to my Trampler here. And if they do block something like this, and if basically I'm banking on them not drawing a land, which actually I know they're not going to draw a land because their Golgari Thug's going to force to put something on top. Okay, so that's fine. So let's go Rally the Peasants makes it so they lose 2 tokens. They don't really lose the Bloodflow Connoisseur. I don't think I care about that. I want to Become Immense the Reckless Worm. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Make a token. And then next turn, they're gonna... Oh, and they can't sack too many things to the Bloodflow Connoisseur. They can sack, I guess they only need to sack the Golgari Thug, actually. Next turn, they're not going to be able to make Spider Spawning again, though they can. What do they get back? A Groundkeeper to make it to get back spawning the turn after. Sure. Okay. And they only take two damage. Then I play Raging Ravine and pass. And then this turn, and it makes their Bloodflow Connoisseur a lot less impressive. They also get to Gold Collar's Apprentice, which actually adds up pretty nicely here. They're gonna Groundskeeper, then Gold Collar's Apprentice. Conflagrate, that's interesting. Interesting. It feels like I have like a lot of options here. So next turn, they're going to make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spiders. So if I attack with the worm and they block with those three. Yeah, I really don't really like how that turns out. So let's go. I can flashback. Let's just go flashback Faithless Looting to kick things off. Because I want to make the most tokens. I don't mind discarding Rally here if I have to. Card looting and rally, and then just kill the... Actually, let's not kill the groundskeeper yet. Let's just play Seder Wayfinder. I don't want to kill the groundskeeper yet, because they're going to flashback spider spawning next turn. Ooh, another Raging Ravine? Sure. I'll play another Raging Ravine. Past the turn here. So they do have spider spawning. That's a powerful engine. But I have a young Pyromancer, which is also a pretty strong engine, and mine keeps going. So they're going to spawn here, but then they're done. They only get four tokens, actually. Because they got Groundskeeper and Zombie back, so it's actually not the worst. So I have seven mana, so I can conflagrate for three. Yeah, that sounds fine. I'll kill Groundskeeper and a Zombie. I guess I could conflagrate my opponent for three and then try to get up to 10 cards. That seems, with Fiery Temper in the graveyard, that seems ambitious. Let's just do this. They're going to make their Bloodflow Connoisseur even a little bit bigger. At some point they get to Chainer's Edict me as well. That doesn't matter too much. Pass. And I think with my flashback cards I can kind of grind my opponent out here. Golgari Thug. Or they dredge Golgari Thug the turn they cast flashback Spider Spawning, of course. But they kind of missed. They can attack with their Bloodflow Connoisseur. I think they might want to start doing that, actually. Let's Faithless Looting here. Because it makes me a token. Doesn't help with Conflagrate, but... get some lands out of the way. Now I kind of wish I had that Groundskeeper back. And I guess we'll pass. Conflagrating for two doesn't seem too impressive. And then next turn... So they're going to sack this. So what are they going to get back? Wait, they have another spider spawning? And they're getting back Crow of Dark Tidings? Never mind. I actually might be... I missed that they had the second spider spawn. I'm sure you've been yelling at your screen for hours here. Huh. Wow, we took a game that I thought was like 0% to lose to... Now I think we're likely going to lose. It's kind of impressive, actually. Let's see what happens. They're flashing back Moon of the Unhallowed. They've got a little time here. So now, conflagrate. That removes just one blocker. I can also animate Ravine. What happens? They have 6, 7, 8, 9 blockers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 9 attackers. So they put one on each. But I really don't want to attack the Young Pyromancer. They get to double block Reckless Worm. Bloodflow Connoisseur gets to actually just eat the Reckless Worm. I don't like that. Don't like that at all. The next turn they get to Spider Spawning for a million. I kind of think I'm on the decking plan here. As little as I like that. I just don't think I have good attacks, so I'm just going to pass. And I don't think I'm supposed to play Conflagrate here either. And I've used the one Fiery Temper, so I don't have another one of those. Just looking at ways to burn my opponent out. Olivia's Dragoons, yeah, that's probably not going to kill me. I'm just going to chump here with my tokens. I think we're starting to bow to the inevitability here. Really still don't think I want to conflagrate here. Just pass the turn. And they can all sack Golgari Thug to get back like a Mongrel or something. Or another Crow of Dark Tidings. I kind of want to wait though. My opponent's deck looks pretty sweet. Oh, they just drew a land, so they're going to... Or they just drew a Satyr Wayfinder, which I guess they're not going to cast because getting decked is a real concern here. Despite all my lootings and stuff, I'm actually two cards ahead of my opponent still. Okay, they're going to flashback the Spider spawning, it looks like. Oh, they're going to flashback Chainer's Edge, sure. Canker Abomination, not really what I'm looking for here. Let's pass the turn. That's funny. That one will likely get sided out. Really needed a second Pyromancer to win this game, as it turns out. It's kind of a cool game, though. So this is 5, 6, 7, 13, 15. I discarded a fourth Crow. Wow, my opponent's deck goes hard on this. Alright. And now are they going to Spider Spawning? Yep, they are. Alright. They get 8 more tokens. Alright, so now I probably have to do something here. Okay, Reckless Charge is interesting. I guess it's just a token if I cast it. It's Conflagrate for 6. Conflagrate for 6. One, two, three, four, five, six. This gets me sadly just the one token. They get to sack these three to make their Blood Flow Connoisseur large and in charge. You know, it's so funny how good 1-2 blockers are against a... My opponent didn't even sack. Weird. 1-2 blockers tend to just be really good. Like a Reckless Swarm, right? It would take out 4 1-1s, but it only takes out 2 1-2s. In fact, a 5-5 only takes out 2 1-2s. It's unfortunate. Yeah, I think I'm gonna lose here. Okay, I kind of like this. This actually gives me a little bit more hope. Because now I think I flashback Rally. Because Rally means I have some multiple tokens. Yeah, that's probably good. All right, let's Rally. Peasants Arise. Make me some tokens and... Block, 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 block. Yeah, I don't want to lose Young Peasy here. Yeah, and they get to grow their Blood Flow Connoisseur, but it's okay. I take 7 going to 9 here. Yeah, I'm pretty dead. Not really sure what I'm hoping to draw. Spark Spitter. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Sure. Actually, you know, Raging Ravine is just a better block. Actually, no. Spark Spitter plus make a token off Reckless Charge sounds even better. Let's Reckless Charge the Reckless Worm and then proceed to not attack with it. So right now I can block 3 tokens profitably. Okay, they're going to sack Golgari Thug. To go back up to 9 cards in graveyard. They're getting another Blood Flow Connoisseur. This is wild. This is wild. I think they can also just send like all the spiders at this point, most likely. Well, I gotta block that. Block, 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 block. Okay. Again, still keeping Pyromancer around because I think that drawing a spell is one of my best outs here. And they're losing tokens every turn, but actually, they wanted to play that other Bloodflow Connoisseur first. That would have been a lot better. Faithless Looting's funny because I actually get decked if I do it. So I think I just pass and I just use this to make a Spark Spitter token. Because remember, now I have Raging Ravine as a blocker too. I don't know if I can make enough tokens to satisfy these two gigantic vampires. Alright, so let's animate Raging Ravine. Let's use Spark Spitter, discard Faithless Looting, because at this point I'm not looking to block. And then I guess I put Ravine there. Reckless Worm, Wild Mongrel. So, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. I guess I could double block the Bloodflow Connoisseur with like a lot of things. That doesn't seem like it accomplishes much. So they're gonna sack one additional spider here, besides the two that are getting eaten, to win the day there. I'm gonna take two, going down to four. Oh, they have to decide whether they want to sack tapped or untapped. Because I can actually threaten to kill them on the backswing here with my own crew. Okay. Ooh, another Reckless Worm. That actually could be kind of decent. Because now I can Madness it out with Spark Spitter. Kind of getting a 2-for-1. Uh-oh. Ghoul Color's Accomplice. Yeah, almost anything is going to turn the tide here. I mean, my opponent's already ahead, so I really had to hope they bricked a lot of times. All right, let's discard Reckless Worm. Cast it. And Spark Elemental there. And then now Reckless Worm. Actually, they have one card. Yeah, I can't kill them. So this is 4, 8. So actually at that point, yeah, I should do it this way. 10, so sack 6, 7 things, okay. And then maybe I can mill them out by using a Spark Spitter every turn or something along those lines. Whew, weird game indeed. Okay, so are they gonna trade just for one Reckless Worm here? Nope, they're reaching higher than that. 7, 8. And they're gonna trade for two Reckless Worms. They could sack the two spider tokens to trade for the Wild Mongrel, but given the current circumstances, that doesn't seem great. Okay, so that trades for those two, and then they can play or Ghoul Caller's Apprentice out of the graveyard, yeah. Another Spark Spitter. Is that better? It's probably not better than just animating a Raging Ravine and discarding a Spark Spitter if I need to do that. Like, basically I can discard every card until end of turn, or every card that I have, and make a blocker every turn. And then my opponent eventually gets decked. I don't know, that's the plan. Ooh, Root Waller gives me double duty here. That's pretty nice. Is this really gonna work? Am I really gonna deck my opponent this way? I think that they made a misstep here when the turn they could have played the second Bloodflow Connoisseur. That was a big one. Because now that second Connoisseur ended up being just too small to actually win. And they played it post-combat after making this into a 10-10, which didn't need to be. Pulse Marasa is awesome, because I have a young Pyromancer. Actually, I think I'm going to Pulse Marasa a Groundskeeper here, because Groundskeeper lets me start going off with this Spark Spitter even better. And I can't make a Spark Spitter this turn, but I do want to hit my land drop. And then I'll pass. but I've got a token to block with. And I'm at 11 now, which means that their non-Blood Flow Connoisseur creatures can't quite kill me. This is what I like about Ultimate Masters. I mean, look at the last match. I lost to Foil plus Rune Snare after getting Emrakul Pattern of Rebirthed. Yeah, that's annoying. Them killing my Spark Spitter is annoying, but I think I might actually... Whoa, they didn't attack? Well, then I'm definitely going to have enough to action to win. And then this match, I'm decking my opponent who spider-spawning me infinitely. Actually, I just need to play the one. Also, if my opponent attacks, actually, I might be able to attack them back. Uh-oh, what is this? I don't like it. What? Another spider spawning? Okay. I just can't. This is amazing. Okay. We're dead. Whew, what are my last three cards anyway? Hootie and the Mandrills. All right, so against triple spider spawning, I mean, Vessel of Endless Rest seems fine. It's gonna do something. Don't really have much else. I could side and defy gravity, but no, those are all spiders. Never mind. Oh, Canker Abomination definitely has to come out. Ulamog's Crusher actually seems like it could be okay in this kind of matchup. Good chance I just end up discarding it or whatever, but actually, you know what? I just need to go faster. I can't beat them in a long game, so I'm going to put in a Vessel. But that's about it. All right, I'm going to play first. Oh, yeah, look at this hand. This hand is nice. This has turn 2 Pyromancer, turn 3 Pyromancer, plus Faithless Looting. My opponent does have Maelstrom Pulse and Last Gasp. Whatever. If they have Maelstrom Pulse to kill my two Pyromancers, they've earned it, I guess. I really just can't do anything about that. Hopefully they don't have Last Gasp. No. I mean, that's better than Maelstrom Pulse, but still unfortunate for me. I'm going to wait a turn on the Looting. Because I don't care about missing out on 1 point of damage, and I really want to be able to cast Reckless Worm. Okay, Crow of Dark Tidings. Land, Looting. Discard Reckless Worm removal. Alright. This is the way we drew it up. And... Boom. Let's see. I am not going to offer the Pyromancer for Crow of Dark Tidings trade, though. I am going to Vessel that spider spawning at an opportune time. Yeah, I guess that opportune time is actually now because I want to be able to pump my Root Walla. I'm going to play my land here. Attack with these three. Poodle's just going to trade there. That's fine. I just have to get damage through here. Oh, they milled two lands. Good. That doesn't set up a... Another six spider spawning here. Crow, milling, land, and a blood flow connoisseur. All right. Let's flashback looting before attack in case we hit Reckless Worm. All right, well, now I just discard some lands and hit with Root Wall and Reckless Worm again. Okay, I'm going to pump the Root Wall here. They're going to lose the Crow, and they hit some more stuff. All right, I'm going to play Raging Ravine, because I think it's more likely that I want to attack with Ravine than do this. Here comes a spawning. Yep, for six. Reckless Charge. Six tokens. See, look, if I Reckless Charge Reckless Worm, it just doesn't kill that many things. Yeah, but I think I'm just going to go for it here. Land. Reckless Charge, Reckless Worm. And then send with this, and probably not that, and not the Young Pyromancer. And they get to make some blocks. They can put four tokens on the Reckless Worm and lose three, and then they go chump, chump. Or they can put chump. Yeah, I guess chump, chump, put four tokens on is probably about what they're going to want to do. This is going to be a tough matchup. I thought I was going to deck my opponent, too, after all that. Okay. Sadly, no Become Immense here. Oh, they're not chumping the Raging Ravine? That doesn't make any sense. Okay. And pass the turn. They have the land to flash back to spawning, unfortunately. But now if I draw a conflagrate, I can just kill them. Haven't seen any life gain. Let's go groundskeeper, mongrel, and probably pass the turn. I could groundskeeper back a land and play it, but I don't even know if I want to play it. I think I'd rather just have it in my hand for later. There's Golgari Thug. And another spawning. Okay. We are very quickly back to the burn you out plan, huh? Alright, getting back forest. Draw. Pass the turn. It's just so hard to attack into all those spiders. So many spiders. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 creatures in the graveyard. Really? Okay. Let's see how this works out. So, block, 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 and I take 10? Yeah, I guess so, and then next turn I have to, probably have to do something here. Pump. And then we'll groundskeeper back a mountain, because why not? Let's go ahead and do it this way, and then I can F6, and it's great. Alright. Take 10, and then they flash back spider spawning. Okay. I probably want to draw something here. Looting helps actually quite a bit, because it gives me a token, and lets me see some more cards. Cards, cards, cards. There's Conflagrate. Okay, so I discard two lands. This should be enough, right? Conflagrate you for two. Oh, wait, I'm actually a little short, huh? Wait, Conflagrate you for... No, whether I Conflagrate for two or zero, it doesn't really matter. Because... Groundskeeper. So actually what I'm going to do is Conflagrate two tokens. And then make another token. Oh wait, why did I... That's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to conflagrate for one each. Well, 10, 14, 15, 3, 6, 7. I guess I'm not dead still, but that was loose. I think I go to 1 here. 17 creatures and I block... Wait. Oh, I think I would have died anyway. 17 creatures and I block 7 of them. Taking 10. I guess I would have taken 11. Yeah, I was one short. I could conflagrate my opponent for 2. Oh, they didn't kill me. Whew. Okay. Block. 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 I'm taking 6 here. Sure. Okay, I don't think my opponent knows what's going to go on here. I really punted that one, though. Woohoo! But my opponent repunted, so... I guess I really can't complain. All right, we're going to get a game 3 out of this, because I'm going to get a forest back. Then I'm going to get a forest back. Then I'm going to nug my opponent for 5. Okay. Red, red. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wham. Well... Okay, end of that game. You know, not the tightest I've ever played in my life, but we're getting there. We're getting there. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to get very lucky to win this game. I'm basically going to need to have a really fast start and then finish them up with Conflagrate, and I don't think any of these blue cards really help in that regard. Verdant Eidolon, I guess, kind of does because it can sack for a bunch, but shh. All right. I have to hope that I just get a really aggressive draw. Yeah, I will run it. I mean, I don't know that I'm supposed to mulligan this. I don't think I am. Oh, well, definitely not then, given that I have turn to mongrel. All right, let's attack. Turn 2 mongrel to turn 3 reckless verm. Oh, my opponent has last gasp on the root wall. Sure. That's fine. I will take that. Oh, they don't have a third land. I sense blood. All right, discard Reckless Worm. Cast Reckless Worm. Oh yeah, Mongrel. the bluest mongrel ever, and then hit, and then now, I mean, my opponent could just draw land, play a crow, and be kind of back in it. I guess Maelstrom Pulse would be worse, but this still gives me some hope here. So let's play land, attack. Opponent's going to block Wild Mongrel. I know how they operate. Discarding Rally the Peasants. And then play Spark Spitter and Raging Ravine. And next turn, the Peasants may be rallied. Because I can make a 5, basically if I rally, and if I use Spark Spitter Rally, that's 5, 11 points of trample. That puts them to 2 after they chump the Wild Mongrel. That's not bad. I could also animate Raging Ravine and smash that way. So either way, I think I'd be pretty happy here. Opponent's going to play another Crow of Dark Tidings. Okay. Land. Ooh. I guess that doesn't actually change much. Yeah, let's just go Raging Ravine. Send. And then now they can block Mongrel again. I'm going to discard Rootwalla. Madness. They take 9, going to 4 here. The question is, if they go forest spider spawning, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't think that would have been enough, and we finish at 2-1 after some pretty awesome games. There was a lot of action, and yeah, I really like Ultimate Masters. So, thank you for watching. We got foiled, but it was a pretty good set of games regardless. This was another draft, of course, on ChannelFireball.com. Thanks for your support, and we will see you next time.